Before we start the video, I would like to take a moment to say thanks to all my patrons. I wouldn't be able to keep doing this without you, so thank you so much for all your support. I would also like to say thanks to Richter and Joshua for their tier 3 sub this month, and special thanks to James Williams Bond for their tier 4 sub this month. Last time when we left off, we were still able to move our player around, but we actually added some animations to him, but we're not able to play them yet. In this video, we are going to make sure that we manipulate with these parameters in the animator whenever we press a button so that he will animate accordingly to what you're pressing. We will also make sure that the player is flipping so he faces in the right direction so he won't be moonwalking. To fix this or to flip him, we would have to open up the player actions. Inside player actions, we have a move method. The move method is where we are going to flip him. So let's make an if statement here that says if the player stats dot direction dot x, if that one is not zero, then we must be moving, because if it's negative, we're moving to the left, and if it's positive, we move to the right. Then we will say transform dot local scale. The transform is passed in the move method parameter here. We want to set the scale based on the direction. If we move to left, it should be negative. If we move to right, it should be positive, the x scale that is. So new vector 3, the x value should be based on the player dot stats dot direction dot x. If it's less than zero, what then? Well, if it's less than zero, we are walking to the left, which means we will set it to -1. In the other case, we would set it to 1. Then we need to put in a value for y and z, and that's it. So what we're doing here is simply making an if statement inside our vector 3. So if the x value is less than zero, we use this value for x. If it's larger than zero, we use this value for x. So we walk in the right directions. Then we will have to save this and test if it works. So let's do that. So now when we run it, the player flips to left when I move to left, and he flips to the right when I move to right. But he's still just ice skating over the ground or in the air. We would like him to, what's it called, move his legs. How do we do that? Well, we have a component animator. If we go to the player components, we have an animator, and one would like to access that. So here I will simply say player.components.animator. Dot play animation. Okay, so we need to be able to play an animation. To do that, we need to open up our any state animator. We can add animations right now. We will also have to be able to play an animation. So if we create a new method, a public one called try play animation, and it takes in a string of the animation that we would like to play. And then we will have to make a switch. So we need to switch on the animation rig, because we need to play different animations based on the rig. So we say switch animations, new animation. So the new animation we want to play, we are trying to play an animation based on a name. We look for that animation inside our animations dictionary. When we do that, it returns an any state animation if it exists though. We need to check the rig of that animation we're trying to play. And we can't access that. Yeah, we have that right there. So we switch on that animation rig. And there are one of two outcomes here. It can be a body rig or a legs rig. Based on this, we need to make a method. And this method is made inside another method because we only need to use it inside this method. So let's make a void play animation. And play animation is an internal method inside this method. And we're going to use a reference to the current animation we would like to replace. If the current animation is string.empty or empty like this, then we're not playing any animation at the moment. That means this code will only run when we start the game. That because there's no animation running when the game starts, so we need to start up our animation. If that's the case, we simply say animations new animation dot active true. So we simply just say we don't have an animation already, So we just set our current animation we want to play to true because there's nothing stopping it from that. Then we say current animation equals new animation. So what is this current animation? Well, we have two current animations. We have a current animation for the legs and one for the body. We're going to pass them in as a parameter here. That's why we have a ref, so that it references whatever we passes in as a parameter and changes the original value of the original variable. This means I can go up here and say play animation ref body animation. I copy this and paste it on the legs and I try to play animation and I use the current animation legs. Okay. So I use play animation on the rig body. If the animation I'm trying to play is called legs idle, it checks legs idle and switches on the rig for legs idle. Legs idle would be a legs rig. It will call play animation and reference the current animation for the legs. Then it jumps in here and says, okay, there's no animation already, so we just set it to active legs animation or legs idle. And we set the current legs animation equal to the new animation so that we know what animation is playing at the moment. If the current animation is different from the new animation, and this is an else though, else if current animation is different from the new animation. So if we are playing idle legs and we want to play walk legs, we say animations current animation dot active false. So we set the current animation to false, so legs idle will now be false. Then we say animations new animation dot active true. So the current animation for the legs is now the walk animation. Then we simply just need to write down what animation is current. So current animation equals new animation. Could argue that this is going to be executed every time. So we could move this, I think, out here and remove these lines just to save one line of code. I think we could do that. But keep in mind, if something goes wrong, we should put it back in there. But yeah, because I want to do like this, because there is a chance we want to play the same animation again. If we try to do that, we don't want to just run this line of code. Doesn't really matter, but let's just keep it like that. Anyway, this play animation is now running inside try animation. So we try to play an animation based on this. If it exists, we will play the animation for the current rig. Keep in mind that this is going to change over time, or there will be added stuff to it. This is not the complete method. I'm just implementing one step at a time to make it easy to understand, because we will be expanding on lots of the code here. Okay, so where do we play this? Well, we need to go to our player actions inside the move method. So let's do that. And here we say, if the direction is different from null, we say animator.tryPlayAnimationBody_walk. How do I know I need to write body_walk? Well, if the direction is different from zero, then we are walking. And we also need to walk the legs. How did I get these values here? Body walk, legs walk. Well, we got them from the player when we created our animation. We want to play this one and this one. And these, remember, they are based on the parameters out here. Okay. With that done, we can jump back to play actions. So when do we need to idle? Well, let's actually save that. Let's try to save. And let's call move somewhere. Where would we like to call the move method? Well, the move method should be called inside the player. So go to player, find update. And it's actually already called here. Good. We also need to do something else. We also need to execute the animation somehow. Because the any state animator here can't play the animation sprite. It plays an animation, but it doesn't run it. So how do we animate it? Well, we do it with this private void animate. Not print, but private. And let's also write private up here for the play animation. Looks, actually, it can't be private because inside and other. So let's do that. That's why I didn't put it there. This one is outside of try play animation. So we just cut this out and put it out here. The only method that goes inside the scope of an other method is our play animation method that goes inside here because it's only used here throughout the whole program. So animate, what should it do? Well, for each string key in my animations.keys, animator.setBoo key animations key dot active. So what are we doing here? Well, when we play an animation, we are telling it that the active, what is it called, boolean, give me a sec, just want to open up the active boolean here that is sitting on any animations we have. Well, that one we set to true. Well, that's all good. We can set them to true, but we're not using it right now. So we need to run through all the animations inside the animations rig here and say, well, our animator should update the state of that animation by saying animator.setBool, take the key, which is the name of any animation, and set that to active or to active true or false. So what this does is that it runs through all the animations basically, checks the active status, and applies the active status of an animation to the parameters out here. So if I go in and say play animation legs idle, it will change the legs idle's active status, and this one will change the parameter status based on the animation status inside this animation dictionary. Okay. So then we have animate. Where do we call that? Well, we should just call it update. So let's do that. And then we say animate. And that's it. So now we are calling it on every frame, and we could argue that we only want to call it when play animation is executed. When we want to switch animation, we can try that. I haven't tried it because right now we're doing this every frame running through everything. We could try to actually take it. Let's see if it works and call it in here. So every time we try to play an animation, we update everything and we call animate. Okay, so let's try to save this and leave it there. And let's leave update out for now then. It's just an idea I just got that we don't need to call an update maybe. So let's see here. Should update out here. There we go. So let's try to run. And what happens? If I start walking, it will start walking. However, it's not going back to idle yet because it keeps saying legs are true and body walk are true. So we need to cancel these and make these true from the code. How do we do that? Well, it's actually fairly simple. We go to our player actions because that's where we have all the action, and we simply say that else if our player.components rigid body, not compare tag components, rigid body dot velocity is vector 2.0. So if the velocity of the rigid body is 0, that means that we're standing still, we are not falling, we're not jumping, we're not walking, we're not doing anything. Well, in that case, we say copy this, paste it down here, and replace walk with idle. In that case, we play our idle animation. Let's try to run it and see how it does right now. and we start walking. I let go, and I'm idling. Walking, and I'm idling. Walking, idling. So now we have a character rig that can switch animations based on player input with a walk and an idle animation. And all this is based on our any state animator. That's what I want to do in this video, so thank you so much for watching.